raft of elaborate activities put together by the state to send home one of its illustrious sons. Former President of the Republic, Flight Lieutenant Jerry Rawlings, entered the second day today. Many individuals from private and public life have been eulogizing the memory of the late NDC founder. For members of a party, he was an enigma. He was a founder and a leader whose values and principles will live with them.
He was the one who sent me into politics. If I say I'm a politician now, I give my credit to him because I followed his principles, I followed his vision. He came and served this nation and served it well. But some people have their own views about him. In fact, one will not live in this world having 100% perfection. But the truth is that the positive side far, far, far outweigh his negative things that he came on this earth to do.
Jerry Rawlings was the expression of what the youth at any one time would do for this country. We must be guided. That was a young man who stood up to do something for this country. It's not over, eh? We always have to remember, what could the youth ever do about this country when things don't look that good? That is all about Rawlings, I think.
This is a man who was true to himself and his principles right from the time he burst onto the scene to the time he died. This is an African leader. As is lying down here today, we cannot talk of any secret bank account anywhere. We cannot talk of chains of houses anywhere in Ghana or abroad. That is the level of integrity. For somebody to have been in power for all these years, 19 years, and yet he didn't grab and amass wealth for himself, but focus on the development of the people, development of the country, the empowerment of the people. I think it's a great example to all of us and to the up-and-coming generation who are into politics.
For politicians like the founder of the All People's Congress, APC, Hassan Ayariga, and founder of the Ghana Union Movement, Reverend Christian Andrews, the life and legacy of a late former President Rawlings should be a shining example for politicians the world over.
Even though I went to exile because of former President Rawlings, in 1979, my father was an MP under the regime of Dr. Hilal Imam when he staged the coup. I was a victim. But we've come to learn that if you don't stand on principles, you'll not be able to correct the future and determine the future. Our democracy has grown through that. Our democracy has become better through that. And I have learned a lot to understand that politics is not about all that you want. Sometimes some people make certain decisions that you might think is against you. But if you look at it, it's in the larger interest of everybody. He's made his several decisions, good, challenging ones. And of course, he's been loved by many Ghanaians.
If it is somebody to copy, a mentor for a politicians in this very country, none of these politicians on this very current situation, you shouldn't copy any of them, but copy Rawlings, because he's the one that is a legend, the one that he left behind. You see, he was selfless. He didn't need to, even the time that he said he wanted to go and do an operation for the wife in London, he didn't even have a foreign account. But look at the politicians now, they are buildings here and there everywhere. But if you want to sacrifice to this very country, just put yourself there, then you should copy Rawlings. You have done a lot.
NPP's organizer Sammy Ewuku wants politicians and ordinary Ghanaians alike to emulate the virtues he stood for.
That was a great leader, and Ghana will surely miss him. He stood for some principles, he stood for some virtues and some values. It's our hope and prayer that even though he's done his bit and left for the ancestral world, the rest of the younger generation and the rest of the people will also carry on with his values of probity and accountability and the very social justice that he fought for.
For his friend and former Chief of Defense Staff of the Ghana Armed Forces, Brigadier General Joseph Nunu Mensah, the NDC founder left behind a legacy even though some families continue to remain embittered by fallouts from some of his actions.
You know, I had a personal example of what happened in 1979. I was in the military with him. My children were under fire. And then my neighbors, who were next to me, both the man and the wife were killed. What I tell their children? You see, these things are terrible. And you cannot console somebody who lost his mother and his father on that day. But what you should remember is that these kind of situations were not prepared by him. They happened like an earthquake, and you don't know what to do about them. What you should do is ensure that they don't happen again. To those who suffered, you know, my heart goes out to them. He himself regretted that people lost their lives.
Representatives of the Queen Mother's Foundation remember him for his honesty and fellow feeling.
I said, Obia, so unse, da krope, da oso debeko. So Obia, obo obra, na washe ye, no kredie, kiki, memo Obia, nye kiki. Yemfa no kredie, yemfa mobra.
Ye wa se, mi se, Obia, oman bebi ano, da wa se, ubi sa se, dia de betu mi aya mamemai. And yet, a dear, and I remember to me, I am mammy. And to going down the history books, you know, or be I heard you bet me, I am boy of my Ghana, said your Ghana, but funding to my paper.
While the state gives the late former president a fitting send off, opinions remain split over the legacy he leaves behind. But whichever way you look at it, there's something definitely to learn from his life and time on earth. Komla Adum, TV3 News, Accra. Thank you.